Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Cooperman, president and founder of ConsumerLab.com, and I'm here to talk today about our tests of dark chocolate bars, cocoa powders, nibs, cocoa supplements, all kinds of cocoa-based products, cacao-based products that contain high levels of flavanols potentially. On the other hand, they may also be contaminated with the heavy metal cadmium, which is a kidney toxin. So we're basically looking, when we test these products at Consumer Lab, to determine the levels of these two key compounds, cadmium, flavanols. We're also looking for other heavy metals. Fortunately, we didn't find significant amounts of lead or other heavy metals. So why even bother eating any of these products? Well, first of all, it tastes great if you like chocolate. Second, these flavanols can have health benefits, modest health benefits. Basically, studies have shown that the cocoa flavanols can relax blood vessels, slightly lower blood pressure, slightly improve certain aspects on a short-term basis of memory and cognition, very mild effects on the benefits for the skin in terms of wrinkles, and some other benefits as well. So let me get into really what to look for when you're choosing these products. And these are just some examples of products that we just recently tested. We've tested many others. And all of this is in our report on ConsumerLab.com, where we show all the information, our top picks. And if you're a member of ConsumerLab, you can certainly get those reports on many other health foods and all types of dietary supplements, which we've been testing now since 1999. So first, in terms of dark chocolate and cocoa, when you look at a product and it says, say, you know, 90% cacao or cocoa, what that means is the amount of cocoa liqueur that's in the product, as well as cocoa butter. These are the two things, kind of key components of cocoa beans. And by the way, you can actually buy cocoa beans roasted and cracked as cocoa nibs as well, which we also tested. Here are what cocoa nibs look like. The issue, though, when you're looking at a label is that since they're combining the cocoa butter, which has no flavanols, with the cocoa liqueur, which contains flavanols, you can't tell from the percentage on a product really whether it's going to be high in flavanols or not. In fact, we have found that products say that claim to be 72% cacao may have more flavanols than, say, a product that's 90% cacao. In terms of the cocoa powders, people typically use about 1 tablespoon of cocoa powder, 5 grams per cup of cocoa. And what we found there is a tremendous variation in the amounts of flavanols. And one of the big determinants there is whether a product was Dutched or treated with alkali or alkalinized or not. And this is what a cocoa powder looks like that has not been Dutched. It'll have much higher flavanols than, say, a product like that looks like this, very rich dark chocolate color that has been Dutched or alkaline treated, because that reduces the flavanols. It can reduce it by as much as 90%. You know, sometimes it's maybe half as much, but we did find that the amount of flavanols in cocoa powders can vary tenfold, even within a brand, whether it's Dutched or not. So if you're trying to get higher levels of flavanols, don't get a product that's Dutched. If you don't really care about the flavanols and you go more for taste, the Dutched products are less bitter. When you're dealing with dark chocolates, you have the same issue. Products that are Dutched, again, will have lower levels of flavanols. Now, the good news is in our most recent testing, late 2019, we found at least one cocoa powder that had a decent amount of flavanols and very little cadmium, which is a very different case from some other products which might have had higher flavanols but much higher levels of cadmium. There is a limit as to how much cadmium you should get. Canada has set a limit. For adults, it's about 4.1 micrograms per day. For kids, it's about 3 micrograms per day. California has a similar limit based on the 4.1 limit. Many of the cocoa powders will exceed the limit for children, Nearly all of them will, except for a couple that we found this year. Some will also exceed it for adults. So, you know, if you're just buying something off the shelf, I wouldn't have more than one cup of cocoa per day to play it safe. If you know what's in there, you know, you look at our report, you can go a little higher. In terms of how much flavanol you actually want to get cardiovascular benefits, memory benefits, you need at least 200 milligrams per day, 500 milligrams, actually the memory benefits kind of kick in there, even up to 900 milligrams per day. It's hard to get that with some of these products. You can turn to a cocoa supplement, which is made from a cocoa extract, where they've extracted the flavanols out, concentrated it, and put it into basically a powder within a pill. On the other hand, there are cocoa flavanol supplements that we've tested that were virtually the same as cocoa powder. They were not extracts, and they really contained just a couple of milligrams of flavanols versus the hundreds of milligrams that you'll get from a capsule of a very good cocoa flavanol extract. In terms of the cocoa nibs, unfortunately, they are also contaminated with some cadmium. So, you know, you need to go easy with those. None of them really passed our test because based on the suggested serving sizes, they all exceeded the 4.1 micrograms per day, but there was one that was better than the others. And again, all of that is in our report. So that's about it for cocoa and chocolates. Again, if you go to ConsumerLab.com, you will see the results for each of these products. We also have price comparisons, information also about the calories that you'll get from eating each of these products. For example, if you choose one of the very high flavanol cocoa, dark chocolate bars, you can eat only basically about a third or less than from another, you know, high percentage cacao dark chocolate to get the same amount of flavanols. And you'd obviously be reducing your calorie intake, you know, by a third as well. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to post them where you see this video. We put these videos out with every review that we publish, so you may want to subscribe if you want to see our next video and be alerted to that. Also, we encourage you to join Consumer Lab so that you can access all of our information. We've been publishing these reports since 1999 and have covered nearly every type of dietary supplement, as well as all types of important healthy foods like dark chocolates, olive oils, etc. Again, this is Dr. Todd Cooperman. Thank you for your time. Bye-bye.